by the sea, by the beautiful sea. You and me, oh how happy we'll be. When each wave comes a-rolling in, we will duck or swim, and we'll float and fool around the water, over and under and then up for air. Now we're rich, what a switch, so what do we care? I love to be beside your side, beside the sea, beside the seaside, by the beautiful sea.
Welcome to beautiful Revere Beach. My name is Matthew Nash, and I work for the Massachusetts State Parks, called the Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation. And I'm here with Lucy the Leatherback. And we would like you to be a friend of sea turtles by keeping the land and sea litter free and create a litter sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need volunteers like you. And look at all the trash inside her. We got straws, toys, cans, plastic bags, bits of lawn chair, ropes, line, and bags from the fishing industry. What else? Plastic water bottles. Do we really need to drink water out of a plastic water bottle when a reusable one would do? So we want you to be a friend of sea turtles. And how can you be a friend of a beautiful sea turtle like this? Well, or a beautiful leatherback sea turtle like this. This is a leatherback sea turtle. They come to our oceans off the coast of Massachusetts, all the way up to Canada coastline, to feed on jellyfish. They're here every summer. They're a huge turtle, about 2,000 pounds and 6 to 8 feet long from head to tail. So the beautiful leatherback, it's called the leatherback sea turtle because it has leathery skin, like my wallet. Okay, very soft and leathery skin. It doesn't have a shell on the outside. It actually has bony plates underneath its skin that can collapse when it dives deep in the ocean in search of its jellyfish. So, leatherback sea turtle, one of our biggest and most impressive sea turtles, one of my favorites. He has a painting of a leatherback sea turtle catching jellyfish. Actually, up to 50% of their energy needs are met here in New England waters up to the coast of Canada. And that's their yearly energy needs. And the Atlantic coast leatherbacks are doing much better than the Pacific populations because of this. They're eating more jellyfish, they have more energy to migrate more often to their nesting grounds. And so they're nesting more frequently, the leatherbacks here in the Atlantic, than the ones in the Pacific. And that's all because of our abundant jellyfish and their ferocious feeding off those jellyfish. So here we have a picture of a jellyfish, but next to the jellyfish is a plastic bag. Unfortunately, these leatherback sea turtles mistake plastic bags and plastic bottles and cigarette butts even for jellyfish, and they eat them, and they get sick, and they die. And this is an endangered species that's dying. This sea turtle could become extinct like the dinosaurs. Do we want that to happen, or do we want to be a friend of sea turtles?
Thank you.
I have a sea turtle toy here, a stuffed sea turtle. Now, sea turtles cannot go in their shell. Only land and pond turtles can do that. Why? Because to go in their shell, they need an opening for their head to go in, they need an opening for their flipper to go in, but if they had that opening when they're swimming, the water would go in and out, slowing them down. And they need to swim really fast away from This is Shark Week on television. They need to swim away from sharks. So they have front flippers to swim with and back flippers to steer with. They have a top shell, a bottom shell. What's different about the bottom and the top shell? See a hand raise. What? Not that they're soft. This is a toy. It's all soft because it's a toy. A real one, it would be hard on both top and bottom. Yes? They're different colors. It's dark on top and light on the bottom. That's so that they can be camouflaged in the ocean. What does camouflage mean?
Can't see.
Yes? Can you speak up? Yeah, blending in. Your colors and design are blending in so that... How does it protect them? Right, so that...
They can't get eaten?
Right, so they don't get eaten by the hungry sharks. So, it's dark on top because when a shark is swimming over looking down, it's going to see the top shell that blends in with the deep, dark ocean. If a shark is swimming underneath and looking up towards the sunlight, this lighter bottom shell is going to be camouflaged against the skylight, the sun shining through the ocean, and it's going to blend in and be camouflaged. And this may be the reason, I'm saying this for the older boys and girls, this may be the reason they survived when the asteroid hit Earth. Remember that big asteroid hit Earth during the Cretaceous Tertiary time period? Well, we think sea turtles survived that because they swam all around the ocean. They were able to find food and go to the better areas, even during very troublesome times here on Earth. All right, so back to how old they are. What scientists do is they'll take a little piece of this white shell, and say this turtle is named Lucy. They'll take a little piece of the white shell and they'll surgically insert it on the top shell right here. So they know Lucy has a white spot here, and when they collected Lucy, they knew she was a baby, so she just hatched. And then they tried to collect her later to see how old she is. Make sense? Guess what? It's really hard to find Lucy again. Because remember, there's very few turtles, and very few sea turtles are all endangered, one step away from being extinct, and they swim all around the ocean. But we're learning, there's sea turtles in the aquariums, and when those sea turtles die, we'll get an estimate of how old they are, but how old they are in captivity, not in the wild. So it's really hard to know that. So let me put this sea turtle away. Or any of you want to touch it?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right, so you want to touch it, we'll have you touch it. Now this is not a real turtle, it's soft.
It's hard.
I can come over here.
Everybody's like, yeah, okay, kids, yeah.
Don't worry. So, sea turtles lay eggs on beaches, but not on Revere Beach. The sand is not warm enough for long enough. The sand gets warm enough for eggs to hatch, but not long enough being warm for them to hatch. So, on places like in Florida, they'll climb up on a beach and the females will lay their eggs in the sand. They'll dig a big hole in there. They're about the size of a golf ball, and they lay about 100. So, the loggerhead sea turtle eats snails, delicious snails. It catches the snails in its jaws, and it squeezes down like a nutcracker with its strong jaw muscles and cracks that shell, just like a walnut in a nutcracker. I have a waved whelk. It's a snail in the waters off of Revere Beach. Do you want to try to squeeze and break this in your hand?
Yeah.
All right. Come on, guys, you can do it.
So the loggerhead's jaw muscles are so strong it's able to squeeze down and break this, and then it eats the shell and all the meat inside. We're going to try to break it with our hands. Ready? Pass it real quick. Squeeze, pass it down. Squeeze, pass it down. Squeeze, pass it down.
Oh, let's do this.
Keep passing it. No, real quick. Squeeze, pass it down.
go strong, little
tomatoes. Yeah, squeeze, pass it down. Really quick.
Nope.
Do you ever, do you know, ever hear us of a sea shanty? It's this. Alright, ready? Alright, so how it goes, we're gonna say, be a friend of a sea turtle. Come on. Come on, respond. Be a friend of a sea turtle.
Be a friend of a sea turtle.
Awesome. Keep the land and sea litter free. And create a litter sculpture in a song about me. And create a litter sculpture in a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need you. All right, one more time. I didn't do the sea shanty so well throughout that. I be a friend of sea turtles.
Be a friend of sea.
Be a friend of sea turtles.
Be a friend of sea turtles.
Keep the land and sea litter free.
Land and sea litter free.
Keep the land and sea litter free.
Keep the land and sea litter free.
And create a litter sculpture and a song about me.
And create a litter sculpture and a song about me.
Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need you. Volunteer, and thank you for coming to volunteer to help with the cleanup today. So, in this box I have things that are very, very dangerous. If anyone my pretties brave enough to reach in and find out what the dangerous things are in this box? You brave soul, come over here and find out what's inside. These things, this bottle is very dangerous to sea turtles. This floated in the ocean. And look at all the bite marks. Those are real bite marks from a sea turtle. So the sea turtle ate the plastic, and it got sick from eating the plastic. And if they eat too much plastic, it gets clogged in their throats or gets clogged in their bellies, and they don't have any room for good food. Are you ready? You reached it. So these are real bite marks. If you see a bottle with triangular marks, this was given to me by Dr. Amos, who studies litter at the University of Texas A&M, so that you could enjoy it today. All right. Is anybody else brave enough to reach in? Right here. You, reach in.
No! Take a chair.
Oh, two things.
Two things.
Let's start with the shark.
Poor sharks are dangerous.
Now, sharks are very dangerous sea turtles because they eat them. And this is a toy plastic shark, and if this gets in the ocean, it's very dangerous to sea turtles because if sea turtles eat it, so if this is floating in the ocean as a toy, a sea turtle may eat it and get sick. So this, a real shark is very dangerous to sea turtles, but even a toy shark, a toy plastic shark, can be very dangerous to sea turtles. He also found a plastic bag. When plastic bags float in the ocean, particularly white or clear plastic bags, what do you think they look like when they float in the ocean? Jellyfish. And what sea turtle eats will eat these thinking that they're jellyfish? Yes, leatherback sea turtles eat these thinking they're jellyfish. All right. Oh, a can. They eat cans by accident when they float. There's one last thing there. Yep, you find it. It's still in there.
Don't open the bag.
Oh, wow. A balloon! I was out at Stellwagen Bank. It's a National Marine Sanctuary. I was out there this winter on a boat looking for birds, and we found these, and we collected these. These are balloons. Someone had a, it says happy birthday. Someone had a birthday, and they let the balloons go in the sky, and they went up, 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 up. And they pop and come down. They can pop and come down in the ocean where sea turtles can eat them and get sick. Or they might land on the street here causing a car accident. And then after landing on the street, the rain can wash them into a river that flows to the ocean. And then they're in the ocean where sea turtles can eat them and get sick. So when you let a balloon go, even for a happy occasion, it's litter, it's littering. And littering is very harmful for sea turtles and other sea animals. So now the next step, we all become, we be a friend of sea turtles. Remember that song? So I have a litter grabber, also called a nifty nabber. These are not canes. I don't want to see people using these as a cane. And they're not to pull heavy things out of the sand. They're for little things like this cigarette butt here, or for a can, or for a balloon. And we're gonna be collecting all kinds of things. We're gonna be collecting things that entangle sea animals, like ropes and nets. We're gonna be collecting balloons and smoking items, deadly balloons and smoking items that are on the beach that get into the ocean where sea turtles eat them and get sick. We're gonna be collecting deadly pieces of foam and plastic from cups, straws, and then lastly, we're also going to be looking for toys, lost toys, that if they end up in the ocean, sea turtles can eat them and get sick. But I should have enough of these grabbers for everyone. So grab one of these buckets, either up here or on the wall. The ones on the table have to be separated, and we'll get to you.
Anthony, take the land. Go. Oh, can I get that grabber? So
yeah. Now.
Anthony, let's Leslie. Take the land.
Any of the litter. So what did I just say? Alright, I need everybody saying that. Do not
touch any of the litter.
At this stage, do not touch any of the litter. Alright, let's go out to the beach.
Celebrating.
My name's Matthew Nash, and we have here Yu Bing, one of the volunteers with us today. She came with the New England Aquarium Live Blue team, and she collected some of the litter. This is litter that's been collected after our beach rakes. Those are big beach rakes, those big machines that rake the beach. This is after prison crews cleaned up the beach. There's still more litter. We also have staff drive around and walk around picking up litter from the beach as well. And look at all this. It's still there after all that work. Another thing the DCR does, we put covers on our barrels, and the staff regularly empty them so that that trash doesn't overflow and end up on the beach and in the ocean where sea turtles can eat it and get sick and die. So some of the things we found. Yu Bing, you want to talk about some of the things you found?
Most of the things that we found are plastic bags, plastic containers, and trashes, and also cigarette butts, straws, plastic bottles, trashes, cups, papers, paper cups, some of the left food leftovers, and those, I don't know how to say this, but...
Bottle caps?
Yeah, bottle caps. And, oops, those bands. Those are the primary things, I think, in there.
So Yu Bing, what is the most common thing you found? Again?
Cigarette bags and all right. Plastic bags.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay.
So I think those are the most of the things that we have found on the beach, and I think we need more volunteers here to help us clean up.
Talk about what you found.
A lot of cigarettes, wrappers, sticks,
straws.
There were a lot of rubber bands.
Wood.
Yeah.
That they could have
plastic
pulled and choked on.
Too
yeah.
Much plastic. Mm-hmm.
And cigarettes.
There are even like bottle caps.
And some glass too.
Yeah, and rubber. We found rubber bands and silly bands too.
So.
Oh, this is something odd.
Olivia.
A cocoa puff.
Olivia. And there's a lot of wood on
here. And we found a lot of cigarette butts over there.
Oh God.
Yep. A milk carton. A tray. Couple of bags and cigarette butts and coffee.
Yeah.
So we are going to make turtles today. You're going to make them with. You bring the plates. Did Leslie bring the plates?
Wait, do we have to make?
All right, wait. You're going to make turtles with plates. I have, everybody's going to get crayons. You're going to get glue. Scissors are on the bench. There's construction paper to cut the head and the flippers with. You're going to cut heads and flippers. And you're going to glue. You can put something on it. Maybe you want to say, be a friend of sea turtles. Hey. Everyone needs to all eyes on me. One, two, three, all eyes on me.
Guys, over here.
Hey, when you're making your little sculpture, you're sending the message to people that sea turtles are harmed by litter when they eat it. We all need to be what? Let's say it. Be a friend of sea turtles.
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 Be a friend of sea turtles. Keep the land and sea litter free.
Keep the land and sea litter free.
We make a litter sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need you. Whatever you can do. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need you. So you want to get that message, sea turtles need our help. Be a friend of sea turtles by keeping the land and sea litter free. You're going to glue on litter, write on it with crayons, color with crayons, cut out flippers, and glue on the flippers.
We're getting the paper plates.
All right. So what we can do now is go to a table. I need to look at the trash before you get started. And I need all the litter grabbers.
Excuse me?
So here's what the heads and clippers look like. You're gonna have to make them smaller. So you can staple the head on when we get everything.
We will save the turtles no matter what it takes. We guys want to find
something. Now, if you want to shape it on your hand.
Yeah, I think it's going to fit.
Okay, we have our
nail. No! Glue!
So either staple things, the clippers and head on, or glue them on.
Okay.
With this, try not to lose the top. So remember where that is.
That glue is not really helping.
Do it. Thomas, come on. The cigarettes are all over me.
I want to put the lead in his mouth.
I let her totally fail this. There. Maybe I can, maybe I can't.
Wait, why'd you put it in the middle?
Totally aced that.
Oh.
Our turtle is adorable.
It don't matter. Okay, let's save one of the little legs. Like this.
You might want to cut them.
Okay, I got this. I got the pie.
You're done with all of it?
Okay.
Oh,
very bad job.
That's right, because we can always flip it around.
Oh, I'm not gonna name it Bob. I'm gonna name it Bobby.
I'm gonna name it Bob.
Alright.
Grab
that straw.
I found it. I really got it. I'm gonna add some of the tea.
We should have cut it out before. Bam.
Why are you cutting out the ball?
Because so we can do the wash.
Oh yeah. So you want me to like start making those little holes?
Yeah. No, let's staple it. We have to staple it.
Yeah.
Let me staple it.
You glue, I staple.
Put it in a bag.
Volunteers from Lake Blue and Lake Aquarium helping. They helped all day educating about marine debris and the problems of sea turtles eating it. They cleaned up the beach and now we're cleaning up all the things we set up today.
Sea turtles, keep the land and sea litter free.
create a little sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you.
Of sea turtles, keep the land and sea, litter free, create a little sculpture and a song about me, whatever you can do, us sea turtles need the help from you.
Ready? Be a friend of sea turtles, keep the land and sea, litter free, create a little sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you! Woo!
I want Vero Beach to be America's first litter-free beach. Woo! It's not impossible. Let's sing together. Be a friend of sea turtles, keep the land and sea litter-free, create a little sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you! So, Revere Beach be America's first litter-free beach. Revere rocks. It's a place of first.
Be a friend of a sea turtle.
Be a friend of a sea turtle. Keep the land and sea litter-free. Create a little sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you.
One more time.
Be a friend of sea turtles. Keep the land and sea litter free. Create a litter sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you.
One more time.
Land and sea litter free. Create a litter sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you.
Ready again.
Be a friend of sea turtles. Keep the land and sea litter free. Create a litter sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you. Be a friend of sea turtles. Keep the land and sea litter free. Create a litter sculpture and a song about me. Whatever you can do, us sea turtles need help from you.
Revere Beach, America's first litter-free beach.
Woo! Very good.